Welcome to Tangata Pasifika, Nisa Yandra.
Talofa Goto on the show today. Shortland Street's Puamanga Siva gears up for his first triathlon.
I think I've always been prepared for something like this.
A papal blessing for Tonga's new cardinal.
It's a call of God through the Holy Father.
Where do you go looking for a Valentine?
And looking for love, John Pulu's in search of a Valentine.
But first, here's Centre for Lover Sanele Chadwick with this week's Pacific News.
Thanks, Marama and Tom. Well, a viral health expert is warning the Pacific region is on the verge of a chikungunya outbreak following the death of 22-year-old Aife Talangi last month. Talangi died after returning to Niue from Samoa, where it's believed she caught the virus. Auckland University's Associate Professor for Infectious Diseases, Mark Thomas, says Pacific countries need to brace themselves for a chikungunya outbreak.
I think every Pacific island should expect to have an epidemic of chikungunya in the coming years if they haven't had one already. The populations of these islands have not met chikungunya before. Everybody is susceptible to the infection, and when it turns up, it'll cause big epidemics.
Thomas says people should use insect repellent and wear long-sleeve clothing as the virus is transmitted through mosquito bites. The Salvation Army's annual State of the Nation report has hit out at the government for not doing enough to fix Auckland and Christchurch's housing crisis. The report's author, Alan Johnson, says every day dozens of people are knocking on the Salvation Army's door with nowhere to go. And we'll be speaking with Alan Johnson to discuss these issues later in our show. Well, Italy's Pacific population just got bigger after a group of Auckland Tongan Catholics descended into the nation's capital this morning. The group are travelling to Rome to attend the College of Cardinals ceremony after 53-year-old Bishop Suane Patita Paini Mafi was selected as Tonga's first Catholic cardinal. Father Lene Folaumoeloa, who's leading the group to Rome, says the trip is a wonderful opportunity for pilgrims.
Oh, it's awesome. I have been a frequent traveller to Rome myself as a student and for meeting and working, but this is unique. You know, this one has an air of itself and an environment that is so exciting.
Bishop Mafi is one of 20 new cardinals, along with Wellington's Bishop John Dew. The ceremony will start at 11 tonight, and you can watch it live on the Vatican website. And later in the show, we'll talk with Bishop Mafi about his new appointment. That's coming up at 14 minutes past nine. A career as a tradie just got easier thanks to a new scheme to help Māori and Pasifika into trade training. Launched earlier this week, it's a joint effort between tertiary providers, industry and community interests. It will give young people free access to courses like carpentry, auto and electrical engineering and plumbing.
It benefits our people because what it does is it gives young people, our young people, the skills, the training, the education in order to go on and get jobs. And with jobs, you know, we can better provide for our kids, our families and our communities.
Around 500 students are expected to train under the scheme this year. Well, it's a sight for sore eyes and a very welcoming one for Pacific people. The Fred Hollows Foundation, which helps restore eyesight for the blind, has built a mobile eye clinic destined for Fiji. It comes fully kitted for eye exams and surgery and costs $750,000. The foundation says the clinic will travel to remote parts of Fiji to give locals better access to treatment. The clinic's been on show in Auckland and will arrive in Fiji next month. And finally, the Black Caps will have all the momentum heading into the opening match of the Cricket World Cup this morning. Christchurch turned on the fireworks for the opening ceremony on Thursday, where today's match will be played. The Black Caps have dominated Sri Lanka so far this summer, and senior batsman and Samoan Ross Taylor says they're in with a chance to go all the way.
I think we've got a good chance. I think our form leading into the World Cup has been outstanding, and our preparation's been the best preparation leading into a World Cup that I could remember in recent memory anyway. All the batsmen have scored runs leading into it, and the bowlers are all fit and raring to go as well.
And the match begins at Hagley Oval at 11 this morning. And that's your Pacific news for this week. Marama and Tom, back to you.
Thank you, Sanele.